Good humans of the internet, I am back here on the YouTubeify, where all the cool kids hang out, apparently. And today, what we're going to do, I just realised I've got my glasses on and you probably can see a reflection, so I'll take those off. Today, what I'm going to do is I'm going to talk you through a little bit of Affinity. Now, many of you will probably have heard of Affinity now. About 3 weeks ago, it came out, three, 4 weeks ago. By the time this video actually comes out, it'll probably be like 4 or 5 weeks. But design software for creatives, by creatives. I've been using it for about, probably about 18 months, but really kind of more intensely over the last year, because I've been a part of the design advisory board at Canva and part of the advisor team based in Affinity, where I've been helping them develop this software for creative people that use it every single day. And it's been a really fun journey to be on. It's now really, really exciting to kind of show you through a little bit. Now, I am no expert. I don't think anybody can be an expert in anything if they've only been using it for a little bit of time. So what I'm going to do today is I'm just kind of going to give you a little bit of an introduction about how I use it, the things that quite excite me about it, a little bit of my workflow. But the main thing we're probably going to focus on today is like how to build your own studio, because I think that is such a sick little puppy in there. Not like a dying puppy, like sick, cool, not like sick, bad, sad. Do you know what I mean? So we're going to go into that today. I'm going to show you a little bit of the history tool. Like I said, a little bit of workflow, a little bit of masking, things I like. And yeah, it should be fun. Should kind of give you a little bit more of a visual piece to put in to the Affinity puzzle. All right, so screen recording, me doing it, you watching me do it. All right, should be fun. Right, my friends, so here we are in Affinity. Now, I'm not gonna get too distracted. I do want this to be a tutorial about how to set up your own studio. So we're gonna focus on that first. If I end up playing with some things afterwards, then we will do so. But I want to make this a tutorial about one thing, because I can get very, very distracted. I'm already distracted. Get on with it. Right. So this is Affinity. So what we're going to do very quickly is just start as where everybody would start generally, which is obviously with once you open up Affinity, you'll be given this kind of screen, which shows you the different presets and the different kind of canvases you can use. I just had video tapped in here just because it's usually this is the orientation or the kind of canvas that I would use. And just for anybody, it took me a little bit of time to find it originally, but now it's really obvious and it's great. Like up here, there's the little kind of portrait landscape things. So if you're looking to change the orientation of your canvas, that's how you do it up here in the preset orientation. So I'm just gonna choose the vertical video 9x16 here, and this brings it up beautifully here. But as I said, I do not wanna get distracted, and this is about making a studio, so I cannot do any work. Can I? No, I won't. No, I won't. Timmy's told me off. We've already shot this 3 times and I keep messing it up. So, because I keep getting distracted. I love it so much that I keep playing around with it. Today, James, we are going to make a studio. So, as you'll notice up here, the very unique thing about Affinity is it's the first time a piece of design software has done vector, pixel, and layout in one app. So vector being the equivalent of Adobe Illustrator, pixel being the equivalent of Adobe Photoshop, and then layout being the equivalent of Adobe InDesign. So it is the first time that all three of these are in the same app, same UI, same studio, same great. And I can I can go between these different studios. So imagine if I had a whole magazine up here or a whole layout that I was doing, I would be able to edit my vectors, like change like filter layers through Photoshop, all in one active, live, super quick app without having to do different things in different apps and how slow that makes our computers. It's all super, super quick. But, right, so that is just to point out that this is really freaking cool and my favorite thing, one of my favorite things. But, studio, we're gonna build a studio. So, you'll see these three little buttons called Studio Manager. So this is how you start to create your own studio. So if you click on those, you'll notice up here, I've already got a little MBJ one built, but I've turned that off for now. But all you have to do is like swiggle, these little buttons. Swiggle is now a verb in the dictionary, to swiggle. But what we're going to do is we're going to create our very own new one. But as you can see, there's all of these options for different studios as default within Affinity. So if you're obviously big into photography, like you've got your color grading and your retouching bits and pieces in here as well. But as I'm just your very normal, bog standard, visual identity brand logo guy, I'm gonna focus on just creating my own studio. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna call it MBJ Sizzle. MBJ Sizzle. And the wonderful thing here is you can actually clone from another studio. So clone from, obviously I am very heavily vector based, so I want to clone from the vector based studio, but you can clone from others, even other ones you've built. You can see MBJ's down there, so I'm going to claim clone from vector, and I'm also going to go down here and I'm going to find a little picture of my little fluffy face as my thing here. So as you can see, I've now got my little fluffy face as my icon, and you can change, you can add studio icons and blah 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 blah. And then all you want to do is push create, and what you'll notice up on the left hand side here now in the studio panel is I've got MBJ Sizzle. Alright, and I can still clone for all these different ones to go through stuff. But the reason you create your own studio is to customize it to your preferences. Now, like I said, I am very heavily vector-based, so the tools that I like to use a lot are shape-building tools, Boolean, you know, pen tool, pencil tool, and a lot of bits and pieces like that. Obviously, I'd sketch a lot, so wonderful thing that I do want to talk about is image trace being in Affinity now, and that's been super helpful for me as somebody who draws a lot and likes to bring those kind of raw vectors, punk vibe, into vector software. So, but what we're going to do is we are obviously clicked on the MBJ Sizzle Studio, and what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go to these other three buttons to customize the tools in the left hand side bar. So what I can do now is I can go through all of these to add into my toolbar, but what I want to do mainly is I want to go, okay, so what are these? Move tool I want to keep, artboard tool I want to keep, group tool I want to keep, but what is something I don't want to keep? Maybe this stroke width tool I don't need now, so I can basically just pull that off and remove that. Group tool I don't need. I do like this shape builder tool, but I'm going to show you how I want to use that later, so I'm going to remove that from here. Text, yeah, I like the artistic type tool. Place tool, no, not especially not in my vector studio. Lots of logo work I'm doing, don't really need that. But maybe there's something in here I want to add, so you know, maybe this adjustment brush tool I want in, so I can add that in here. You know, the crop tool I'll probably plop in here as well. What else is there? Paintbrush tool, I'll have a bit of that some. Do you know what I mean? So now I've got my tool palette, I would suggest, pretty aligned to the things that I would actually use on the daily, rather than there being a load of stuff, a load of fluff that I would never use. I've been able to customize it to stuff that I will use a lot of the time. So I'm really happy with MBJ Sizzle on the left-hand side. But, my friends, that is not all. There is more that you can do. So if you head to this top bar, you can see there's this big blank space ready to be filled with all of the goodness. And what you can do is you can right click and push customize toolbar here. And what this allows you to do is also create a few shortcuts in the top bar, which is great. And as I mentioned, I love Boolean. I love the shape builder tools, especially as somebody who does a lot of vector work, a lot of logo work. So what I can do is I can drag this into my top bar and it will be there, which allows me a nice little shortcut when I'm playing with shape. So I might go, okay, I mean, you can see I've already got a few things up here, but I want to just show you how it works. I can go, right, I love the kind of central align tool. I love the left align tool. That's important for text. And then the right align tool. So I'm going to keep those in there. Now, what else do I think I like? Flip vertical and flip horizontal, super important for shape building. So I'm going to add those in. And there's a load of other stuff that you can add in here as well. And once I push done, they are now in my studio. So when I start to play around with certain things, I can use these as other little shortcuts. Now that feels to me like a pretty cool customizable space that's now mine. It's very different from all the other ones. As you click through, you can see the difference that MBJ Sizzle is a little bit more compact, a little bit more about the things I want. But I'm like, MBJ Sizzle is the one I'm going to use all the time. So I want that to be on the left. So what you can do, if you just hit these three little buttons again, and then just drag this little guy up to the top and place it at the top, you'll notice that it goes over to the left hand side. And that, my friends, is a very super duper, super simple way you can start customizing your own studio in Affinity. And it is the sizzle. Delicious goodness all round for creatives like me and you. Wonderful. Come back probably next week for some more MBJ sizzle tips in Affinity. Yeah, maybe we should call it that. All right, have a good day.